So good morning dear children. In the day one we have started sets. We have discussed yesterday about the introduction of sets, how to convert roster form into set builder form, set into set builder form into roster form. So these are all we have seen. Now we are proceeding to the equal. First we start with equal sets. What are the equal sets? Suppose set A and B are two sets, have equal number of elements, equal elements, then two sets are called equal sets. Let us take an example. A is equal to, suppose, A, B, C, D. And set B is equal to B, C, D, A, suppose. Here, in set A and set B, the elements are same. Order may be different, but the elements are same. In such case, we will say that A is equal to B, and it is denoted by A is equal to B. So, A and B sets are equal here. Comes to equivalent sets. Suppose in both the sets A and B are any two sets here also. A and B are any two sets. In these two sets contain same number of elements. Then the sets are called equivalent sets. Suppose let us take one example A. A, B, C, D. And set B is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5. Here A contains 4 elements, B contains also 4 elements. The elements are different, these two are not equal. A is not equal to B, but we can say that number of elements in set A is equal to number of elements in set B. That we will write this as N of A is equal to N of B. That means number of elements in set A is equal to number of elements in set B. Here 4, we will write this as 4. So here A and B are called equivalent sets. Now let us take one important concept in sets, subset. What is called subset? If A and B are two sets, A and B are any two sets. Suppose all the elements of set A are present in set B. All the elements of A are present in set B. Then we will say that A is subset of B. For example, we have St. Peter's School. There are many classes. 10th A, 10th B, 10th C. All 10th A, 10th B, 10th C. All these classes are there in St. Peter's. So we can say that all these 10th A, 10th B, or 9th A, 9th B, 10th A, 7th B, all these classes are subsets of St. Peter's School. So St. Peter's School is taken as a set. All the classes are subsets of the set. So A, all the elements are present in A. For example, set A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 elements are there. In set B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So here 1 to 5 elements are there, here 1 to 7 elements are there, but all these 1 to 5 elements are present in set B. Therefore, you will write this as A is subset of B. This is the symbol for subset. A is subset of B. All the elements of A are there in set B. Now suppose let us take here set A. Is set A a subset of every set? Yes. Every set is subset of itself. Even B is also subset of B. Every set is subset of itself. B is also subset of B. So this is called the concept of subset. So subset means population. Suppose take Telangana. Telangana, all the population of Telangana is there in India. Therefore, automatically the population of India is subset of India, Indian population. Suppose it comes to the number system. We can represent this as diagrammatically. Let us take this as natural numbers set. Let us take this as W, whole numbers. Take this as integers. Take as suppose rational numbers. So we can say very clearly, we can say that all the natural numbers are there in whole numbers. All whole numbers are there in Z. All Z are there in Q. So we can say that N is subset of W, W is subset of Z, Z is subset of Q. Therefore, N is subset of W, W is subset of Z, again Z is subset of Q. So this way we can very easily can understand here what is the concept of subset. One more will find the subsets. Let us take one example here. 1, 2, 3. Separately. So if you make separate from this, many sets you can write from set A. There are 3 elements. From this you can write many sets, many elements. Suppose you can say that every set is subset of itself. Already we have learned this one. And if you take suppose one element, one is subset of A. If you take suppose 2, 2 is subset of A. Take 4, 3 is subset of A. 1, 2, 3, 4 subsets. These are all subsets of A. And if you take 2 elements, it becomes 5. 1, 2 is subset of A. 2, 3 is subset of A. 7. 1, 3 is subset of A. And there is an empty set. Later on, you learn that empty set is also a subset of A. So there are, we will find here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all these 8 are subsets of the main set K. So here we can derive one formula here. N of A, how many elements are there in set A? There are 3 elements are there. Therefore, number of subsets is equal to, we will write as 2^3. Is equal to 8. So number of subsets for this particular set 1, 2, 3 is equal to here. 2^3 is equal to 8. Or we can write this way also. Suppose a set contains n of A, there are n elements are there. Then its power set contains 2^n elements. This is very important. There is one more concept here. Sometimes A, 1, 2, 3, B is, here A and B are not equal sometimes. Then we will write this as A is proper subset of B. A is proper subset of B. So when A is proper subset of B, A and B are not equal. So if you take 3 elements here, earlier we got it here 8. Eight subsets of a set, but here proper subset A is not here. A is subset of B, and A is not equal to B. A is not equal to B, so A is removed. Then the formula becomes power of A is equal to 2^3 minus 1. We have substituted here. We are not taking here set A. Therefore, it becomes 7 elements in proper subset. Therefore, according to that, then suppose here. N of A is equal to suppose N elements contains. Its proper subset contains 2^n on minus 1 and subtract. So this is the difference between number of subsets and number of proper subsets. Number of subsets 2^n formula. Number of proper subsets 2^n minus 1. So this is the concept of subset. Children, what we have learned is now equivalent sets, equal sets and subsets. Let us proceed to the types of sets. So what type of sets we have? Let us take first. Infinite set. So what is infinite set? So for example, take how many stars are there in the sky? Suppose let us take how many stars are there. Can we count them? No. Therefore, number of stars in the sky is taken as infinite set. In the same way, how many cells in our cells we have in our body? So cannot be counted. Therefore, it is infinite set. So we can say that now a set which contains infinite number of elements is called infinite set. So once again I repeat, a set which contains infinite number of elements is called infinite set. Let us go to the converse of this. Finite set. So finite set, infinite set. Here elements are uncountable. But here finite set is countable. So how many bones are in the body? We have countable, 206 bones are there. So number of bones in the body is taken as a finite set. Number of prime numbers less than 100, countable. So it is a finite set. Number of even prime numbers, number of children in the school, number of students in St. Peter's school, these are all comes under finite set. So what is a finite set? A set which contains finite number of elements which are countable is called finite set. Next comes to the singleton set. Singleton set, in the name itself, you find a single. Single means one. So a set which contains only one element is called singleton set. Suppose let us take all women prime ministers of India so far. They have only one woman prime minister, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. So she is only one element. So it is called a singleton set. Suppose if you take in mathematics, you get one nice example. P is a set of even prime numbers. How many even prime numbers we have? Only one. So P is a set of even prime numbers. We find only two. So it is also a singleton set. So a singleton set which contains only one element. Next, we will go to one important set. Empty or non-set. Empty set. So what is an empty set? Empty means, you know already, empty means nothing. So a set which contains no elements is called empty set. So children, once again, a set which contains no elements, that means in that set no element should be there, then it is called empty set. So for example, this empty set is denoted by, normally it is denoted by pi, symbol for pi. So how to represent this set? Pi is equal to empty set. So only we have to enclose the power brackets here, we are not supposed to write anything. Suppose if you write pi is equal to 0, if you write it is not an empty set, and phi is equal to 5, it is also if not empty set. So it's very important here, phi is nothing should be there. So here phi 0 is an element here represented, so it is not an empty set. Here this is also not an empty set. So now what we have learned is all the types of sets, equal sets, equal sets, subset concept, everything we have learned. Now we proceed to the basic set operations. We are going to basic set operations. So now how numbers will be add or subtract or divide or subtract. So we are going to proceed. What are the basic set operations? In this basic set operations, first we are taking union of two sets. So what is union of two sets? Union of two sets A and B is a set in which elements belongs to either A or B. Union of sets is a concept. Union of sets A and B is a set in which elements belongs to either A or set A or set B. Suppose this also can be written as, and it is denoted by A union B. This is the symbol for union. And how to represent this? In the set form, A union B is equal to X is a set, X belongs to A or X belongs to set B. So this is the definition of union of two sets. It is clearly a how to find A union B. A union B is nothing but elements belongs to A, either A or B. Let us go for one example. Suppose set A is taken as AEI2U. B is a set MIA. These are the elements. How to find A union B? So A union B is equal to, so definition says clearly, elements belongs to either A or B. So either A, E, I, O, U. So A, E, I, O, U. And here B is there already here. They are not supposed to write. I is there already supposed to not write. O is already there. Next, M is not there. So we have write M and N is also. So these are the elements. So these are the elements belongs to either A or B. Which are not written in A and B, we are not writing here. So this is the concept of union of two sets. And here we have one rule, A union B. If you find for any two sets, A union B and B union A always equal. So you can say that union of two sets is closure property satisfied. That means union of two sets is completed under union. Next we proceed to intersection of two sets. So there is a slight difference between intersection and union. Here also again A and B are union two sets. The intersection of two sets A and B is denoted by A intersection B. This is the symbol for A intersection B. And how to define this? A intersection B is equal to, in the set notation, it is written as X is such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. So A intersection B is equal to X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. That means this set particular element should be there in set A and also set B. So let us go for an example. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And set B contains 4, 5, 6, 7 elements. Then how to find this? Intersection is there should be common elements. The common elements. What are the common elements? 4, 5. Here also common elements are 4, 5. So let us take A intersection B as 4, 5. So A intersection B is taken as 4 and 5. These are the common elements of set A and B, A and B. So intersection of two sets is nothing but the elements common from set A and set B. So before concluding this session, this is day 2. What we have studied, just revise once again. So we have started with equal sets, equivalent sets, the concepts of subset, proper subset. And we have proceeded to the types of sets. In the types of sets, we have seen what is equal, what is infinite sets, what is finite set, what is empty set, and what is singleton set. And then we have proceeded to the basic set operations. In the basic set operations, we have studied about two basic operations today: union of sets A and B, and intersection of sets A and B. So, thank you, dear children. And in the next session, we are going to continue this basic set operations. And about Venn diagrams also, you will be studying next.